Hello, everybody. It's the Doctor, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Star Trek Online, Free-to-Play Edition. We are moving through the Breen Invasion storyline, and we're currently at the last Breen mission, which we'll talk about in a second. But before we get to that, stick around at the end of this video, and I'm going to talk about the Jem'Hadar space set versus the Breen space set, which we will now have all pieces of, and I'm going to compare them and see which one will fit best on our ship moving forward for right now until we get, you know, the next set. Also, we'll talk about some upcoming missions because there's a storyline mission you may not know about that's tied to the reputation that kind of bridges the gap between the end of the Breen missions and starting the next missions called the Solene missions. So I want to talk about that as well. And then we will maybe go ahead and open that Krenim science vessel and go ahead and just see what it looks like and check it out. And at least I'll be able to use that for the Admiralty system, though I'm not going to use it as my primary ship just yet. I'm still going to use the patrol escort, which is really no problem at all doing PvE content with it. I mean, it's doing great. We're at level 53. We're not even at 60 yet. And this is still a good ship for the storyline missions. So there's no reason really to go to another ship at this point. Okay, so let's begin the next mission. It is called Cold Storage. You and your crew confront Thought Trell in a struggle to protect an amazing discovery. Our scientists have consulted with your commanders, and they concur with your crew's theory. If there is an intact preserver library, it is likely to be located in the Leoness system. I suggest that you begin your search on Leoness 3. It has a climate very similar to Defera. If the preservers settled here eons ago, it's possible that they would have chosen a similar world for this facility. Please be safe, but be quick. Long-range sensors have detected Breen vessels in the space near the system. I fear that they have made the same conclusions we have. You must find the preserver technology before they do. So let's go to the Leoness system, which is down here. And we will finish the Breen storyline here, and then we'll have all our pieces. Here's the engine, here's the deflector, and we're about to get to the shield. Nice quick jump to Leoness. Let's begin. Looks like the Breen are already here. Captain, sensors show a skirmish between a small Breen invasion force and small pockets of Alpha Jem'Hadar. Records show that the Dominion had a base in this system during the Dominion War. It is conceivable that the Alpha Jem'Hadar took it over after the Dominion retreated. Neither side will be happy to see us here, sir. I recommend we engage everybody and kill everyone. Basically, that's the goal. Well, that's something I can do.
Warning. Ship is under attack. Target shield has failed.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Oh, yeah. See, our patrol escort ain't bad. Not bad, huh? Nice little ship. May only be a tier 5 ship, but you know what? For storyline content, not bad so far. Sweet. We really only have one more group over here. Tractor beam. There we go. Okay. Well, that takes care of everybody. So this Jem'Hadar set is not too terrible. I like the anti-proton sweep. Okay, let's beam down. Sensors show multiple life forms, Captain, but something is interfering with biological filtering. I can't tell exactly what is out there. I recommend that we proceed with caution, but we need to find the Breen before they can access the Preserver Archive. I'm getting some interesting readings from an object to the northeast. Recommend we head in that direction. Okay, let's do it. All is quiet. Too quiet. There we go. There's some Breen. See what this is. Captain, this device seems to be connected to a subterranean power source. I can't pinpoint the location of the source, but if we can locate an area where the energy disturbance is strongest, then we should be able to triangulate the location. Sir, I'm reading multiple transporter signatures. Yeah, they're already fighting them. I think I'll join you guys too. Why not? Okay. Locate the source of the power fluctuations. More Breen. Totally missed him with that grenade. Awesome. Stop running at me. Go. Some weird noises. More Breen. Ow, I walked right into that. I believe this is power source, yes. Well, not power source, but anomalous reading. Fine neutrino emitter. Fascinating. It appears that the energy readings are faint neutrino emissions. I can only surmise that the archive is powered by an antimatter reactor. and if the preservers were using antimatter reactions thousands of years ago, their technology may be much more advanced than we realize. Captain, if we can locate the antimatter reactor's neutrino emitter, I can use a resonance mapping to chart the whole facility. Nice. You do that then. Here we go. My bridge officers, come on guys, like, help. I'm dying here. Okay, locate the preserver archive. Excellent. We can map out the entire facility from here, sir, and from the looks of it, there have been multiple cave-ins and signs of recent excavation. The Breen must already be inside. I've located a surface entrance nearby. We should get there immediately. Well, apparently, before we do that, we are being attacked. Okay, there we go. Let's go, everybody. Oh, crap, here we go. Scan the obelisk. The obelisk may be the key to accessing the archive. Using the information we've gathered thus far, we should examine it and see if we can provide information on how we might proceed. Secure, oh crap. Ah, ice. It's cold. It's gonna be another wave. I'm ready. Took care of that pretty easily. Examine the results. Sir, when that last group of Breen beamed in, I detected an energy pulse coming from a section of the obelisk. I believe that section to be an access point to the archive. Archive. Enter the archive. Ooh, underground. How clever you are. I see you found the entrance to this ancient weapons store. Too bad your journey will end here at the hands of my most elite. I'm almost sad to see you go after all you've done for me. That is, after all we've been through together. Oh, he loves me. He loves me not. He loves me. He loves me not. He's about to get a phaser blast in the face. Defeat Breen invaders. We got groups of invaders to defeat here. Basically, we've got wave after wave after wave is going to come at us here in a second. After we defeat all the groups. Basically, it's a lot of Breen to get through, but not too bad. Kind of fun. Except for all this, their cold weaponry here is very devastating. Power. aggroed another group. Alright, back off everyone. Let's recover. Who died? Tavrel, why are you dying? Why you always dying? Why you always dying? Both of you, come on. And where's the other group? Oh, way over there. Hiding from me. Oh, why am I always dying now? No want to die.
Flanking damage detected.
Holy crap, I came so close to dying. And I'm still so close to dying, and I'm dead. And Coles, go get him, boy! go get them all! Save us all, Coles, come on! Oh, he's gonna die. Let's see what happens. Is he gonna make it, or is he gonna die? Oh my gosh. Coles for the win. He killed everybody and saved us all. We must need to use these consoles. Yes, we must need to use them. I agree. Preserver archive technology is sound based. So we need to sound them off. So this would be mid. And this would be high. And this would be low. Okay, we need to try. What do we need to try? An ascending scale. So low. Boom. And then mid, and then high. Boy, that's the hardest puzzle ever. No one will ever figure it out and enter the archive. Okay, activate the archive. Then we get to face the big bad boss. The boss fight. Which is pretty intense. I was saving my strike team and my security escorts and my combat triage subroutine for this part of the mission. Didn't want them to be on cooldown. I wanted to save them for this to go up against the boss. Talk to the Preserver Archivist. Welcome, who are you? I am the guardian of all who my people were and all that they remember. My task was to keep the archive safe until the day when our children would be united and would want to know who we were. Welcome, my children. I'm so happy to finally meet you. Tell me about your race. Long ago, life developed in our world before all others. We explored the galaxy, but we were alone. But what is life when there is no one with which to share the joys or the sorrows? So if the galaxy would not give us companions, we would create them. We created you. Our scientists seeded many worlds and directed evolution. We wanted you to resemble us, but more importantly, we wanted you to understand us. Unfortunately, we knew that we would not live to see you become what you have become, and create the great wonders that we knew were possible. Most of my people are gone, and the fact that a fragment of them lives on in you is enough. But we knew that someday you would seek us out, and so a few of us remained, waiting for you and the world that would be. We are the technology you seek. Our main focus of study was the genetic code. We learned how to manipulate this code not only to create dozens of species to seed across hundreds of worlds, but also how to use it to alter our own genetics. You might call us living computers. Each preserver has the genetic memory of our entire race. All of our knowledge and history is stored within each of us. Are there more? Hundreds. While each preserver has the genetic memory of the entire race, it was deemed important to preserve individuals so that if the time came when we could live with our children, there would be sufficient numbers to maintain our species. We built this place and slept, dreaming of the world that would become. We dreamed of the world you would create. What will happen to the preservers now? Some will return to their long sleep. A few may want to see the world their children have created. The galaxy is yours now. We are so pleased with what you have created. And then the Breen comes. This is, of course, Thought Trail. So let's prepare and begin. He's going to have a nice little argument here. Okay, let's do that. Come on. And that. And that. Come on. There we go. Get all that stuff ready. Everybody's ready? Okay, good. Ow. He's gonna go away. Alright, let's take out these guys. Now it's time for the big guy himself. I'm gonna come over here.
Enemy targets on sensor. Personal shield losing power.
Ow. That hurt. And he's gone. We did it, folks. That's it. Cool. That can be pretty hard if you're not geared very well. He's pretty tough. You have to deal with a lot there. Captain, a furry ship has entered the system. They're requesting permission to beam down science teams to begin examining the archive. Word from Starfleet Command is that this will be a joint operation led by the Deferi. Get all my loots. Okay, we don't need to talk to the preserver. We already talked to her. Let's talk to the scientist. Thank you, Captain, for your help. Since I was a child, I've listened to stories about the preservers. I never even dreamed that someday I would have the chance to meet one. But you have made this possible. My people will celebrate this day. The balance has been restored. You have our eternal gratitude.
Well, cool.
Accolade complete, the Breen invasion. We've now completed the Breen storyline. Captain, this is amazing. The preservers are the earliest known sentient race. To find an archive of their knowledge and to find preservers still alive, it's almost too much to take in. We will learn more about the earliest days of the universe than we ever thought possible. The preservers will be able to tell us about the origins of our worlds, and even about races like the Iconians. Teams will be working in this archive for decades. There's so much I want to learn, but I know we have to return to the Arrow. Ambassador Sarah and Starfleet Command will be waiting to learn what we found. You can leave on our... We can leave now, which we are. Good, okay, so that's it. That's the mission. Let's turn it in. You have made a most extraordinary discovery. The preservers are alive. We can learn so much from them. They will have knowledge of the early days of the galaxy that has been lost to time. Perhaps they even remember the Iconians or the Takan Empire. But more important, than even the knowledge we will gain is the safety of my people. The Breen threat has ended, and we have you to thank. For now and always, we will be a friend of the Teferi. May your life always be in perfect balance. Now, we got two options for rewards here, and both of them are good. I mean, if you're going to use the Breen set, obviously you want to go with the Resilient Shield, so you can, you know, check that out. Otherwise, I would go with the CRM 200. It's a very, very cool, literally cool, and no pun intended there. Literally, it's a cool weapon, but it's also a cold weapon. And it is good. It's a good weapon to have. You could put it on a bridge officer, for example, and let them use it. It's got a very, very powerful AoE second ability on it that will do a lot of damage to a large group of people, a lot of cold damage. It is very, very cool. So it would probably benefit me to go ahead and replay this mission and get the CRM 200 as well. I'm going to pick the Breen Shield right now so we can compare the space sets. But I don't see why I couldn't replay this mission and go ahead and get the CRM 200 as well and put it on a bridge officer. Because it's a pretty cool weapon. I like it. Look at that. So close to 54, but not quite. Okay, now that we have the complete space set of the Breen and the complete space set of the Jem'Hadar, we can compare things. But to do that, we need to go to open soul space so we can see what the actual stats and real numbers on these things are. Then we'll compare them and figure out what's going to work best on our character here. Tactical character, flying an escort. So what's going to work best for us? Let me kind of get away from people warping in and everything. And we will take a look at our sets. First of all, you gotta admit the purple with the Jem'Hadar, it looks very good. So there's one thing going for the Jem'Hadar set right there, is it just looks good. Okay. We've kind of already determined that as far as impulse engines go, I prefer to have the Jem'Hadar impulse engine. Because the Jem'Hadar impulse engine adds +5 weapon power and an additional weapon power when the bonus increases when the weapon power is low. And since I'm firing so many cannons, you've seen how many cannons I'm firing. I got quad cannons and dual cannons and everything. I got a lot of cannons going, so that power drain is real. So having additional weapon power is beneficial. Plus, the flight turn rate is just a tad higher. If I upgraded that to a mark, 11 or 12, the flight speed would probably be up to where the Breen is. It doesn't have engine power setting, but I really am okay with that. I would rather have the weapon power setting. So I kind of lean toward the Jem'Hadar impulse engine as far as an impulse engine goes. Let's compare the deflectors. Now on the deflector, I have to say, improved flow caps is on that one, but I don't really use that. It's hard for me to determine which one I really like best here on the deflector. Resist shield drain and energy drain is nice, but I believe that the two-piece ability of the Breen gives us that as well, or something gives us that. Two pieces, something gives us that. No, that's EPS and transphasic, and then the Breen energy siphon, right? So it's the Jim Hadar one that is giving us, yeah, resist shield and energy drain with two-piece. Now, this is giving us Polaron damage with the two-piece. See, I'm not using Polaron energy weapons, so that's not benefiting me. I would have to change all my weapons to Polaron to really benefit that. Let's look at the shield real quick. Okay. Not too different on the shield capacity. I'm actually quite surprised. It does look like the Jim Hadar resilient shield is a little more on the shield capacity side of things, but not by a lot. They both have 5% absorption and bleed through. The regen is the same. Okay, I'll tell you what, I gotta say I like the Jim Hadar shield better though, because check it out, it reduces all energy damage to shields by 10%. The Breen one only reduces Polaron damage to shields by 20%, but it's only Polaron damage, whereas the Jim Hadar is all energy damage. So I like that better. I also like the fact that it has a kinetic damage resistant rating, plus 10, and a plus 75 crew death / disable resistance. Guys, I like the Jim Hadar resilient shield. You know what? I may not be using much of the Breen stuff. I thought I would be, but after looking at these two things, I like the Jim Hadar shield and impulse engine better. I just do. It's really the deflector that is the big thing that I'm not sure what is better. I guess there's really no reason to do that. I might as well just keep the three-piece set to the Jim Hadar going, because again, I also like the anti-proton sweep that I'm getting. The only thing I'm not benefiting from is the increased Polaron damage, because I'm using phasers, but I could change to Polaron, but then I'd have to get all new tactical consoles, and then this phaser quad cannon would not work. I'd have to get rid of it, and I'd have to go Polaron. So really, it's not worth it, and I'm doing a pretty good amount of damage. Guys, I'm going to keep the Jim Hadar set on. We'll keep this in the inventory just in case, but I don't see any reason to use the Breen set on this character. The Jim Hadar shield has a higher capacity. It has an all energy damage to shield by 10% reduction. It has a plus 10 kinetic damage resistant rating. It has a plus 75 crew death disable resistance. The Breen shield has none of that. It only reduces Polaron damage to shields. The impulse engine has plus 5 to weapon power, whereas this engine is plus 5 to engines, not weapon power. And then the deflector is just, I think I like this one better too on the Jim Hadar. And then with all three pieces, I get that anti-proton sweep, which I really like as an ability. So I'm just going to keep the Jim Hadar set on here. I see no reason to use any pieces of the Breen set at all for right now. So what we'll do is we'll just keep that on and we'll wait till the next space set comes along, which if we look in our storyline missions, you can't see it right now, but under the Solene Dyson Sphere stuff that we're about to get into, there is a Solene set. Now, it is more science-based. However, we can compare it with the Jim Hadar and see if there's any pieces of it we like better. I know that the Solene Deflector, for example, is a really cool deflector. It increases your ship health and your shield capacity with that deflector. I know that. So that may be a good deflector. But we will wait until we get that set to compare. So I'm going to continue to use the Jim Hadar set for now. That's what I've determined. Hopefully you guys will agree with me, but hopefully you'll see my reasoning as well for why I'm choosing to keep the Jim Hadar set on right now. Otherwise, yeah, that's that. Now, on the missions, like I said, we will be starting the Solanae Dyson Sphere stuff next. That is really some really cool missions, some really fun stuff, and good rewards and all that. However, there is a piece of missing information you may not know about if you are, let's say, a new player to Star Trek Online and you've never done any of the reputations before. I am referring specifically to the new Romulus reputation. Now, this reputation, of course, allows you to get all the gear associated with the new Romulus reputation, but after you finish each tier of the reputation, like you start off at tier 0, you go to tier 1, tier 2, tier 3, tier 4, tier 5. At the end of each tier, there is a mission that is unlocked. Now, the first one is really simple. It's like, go watch a video. But the second, third, fourth, and fifth ones are like actual missions that you go and complete and do. And in those missions is a storyline that develops. And it's all about an Iconian gateway. That is, I'm going to spoil it for you because you may not know this, but you will find out in the Dyson Sphere stuff we're about to get into, there is a hidden Iconian gateway on New Romulus. So this reputation explores that. So I haven't done any of the reputation right now, as you can see on this character. In order for me to grind it and do all five tiers would take way too long for me to record those five missions. So there's no way I can do that before we start the Dyson stuff. So instead, what you can do is I will put a link in the description and maybe in the video as well that links to a playthrough I've already done of the new Romulus reputation missions, those five that they released. I played them when they came out and I recorded them. So I will link to them on a completely different character that I ran them on. But in that way, you can at least see the storyline, so that before you start watching the Dyson Sphere missions, you will be familiar with what happened on New Romulus. You will be familiar with that storyline. So go ahead and check that out in the description. Maybe I'll put a link here at the end of the video as well. And you can check that out and go watch that before my next video is up that shows the Dyson Sphere stuff. Then you'll be all caught up, basically. So check that out. That's kind of important for the storyline, as far as storyline goes. Next, let us do the Krynim Starship. Okay. Let's do this on Earth space dock. I'm very excited. This is my first opening of this. This is the first time I've ever opened the Krynim Science Ship. So you and I are both seeing it together for the first time and what it's all about. I just want to check real quick and see how many ship slots I have as a free-to-play character. This is something I don't really know. I want to make sure I have a free slot here. Okay, I've got 3 active ship slots left. So that's cool. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ships, and there's 3 more slots left, so I guess you get 9 starship slots as a free-to-play character. So we have plenty. Let's do this. Here is the ship from the 6th anniversary, remember? This is the special requisition pack, Krynim Science Vessel, Tier 6. Let's click it. Here it is, everybody, the Alberta. Congratulations, Alberta has been commissioned into service. You may rename her at any time. Okay, she's got a crew of 720, so pretty large crew. Base hull of 37,957. Of course, that will increase as you go in rank to 60. Shield modifier of 1.48. That's an extremely high shield modifier. I think the highest shield modifier, in fact, for any ship. Typically, science ships do have the highest shield modifiers, and this one, I think, has the highest one. Base turn of 10, 3 fore weapon slots and 3 aft. That's very typical for a science ship. 3 device slots. KO, and it comes with a Crinum Chroniton torpedo launcher. Let's take a look at that. Ooh, we got a torpedo opened up with us. So we've got this Crinum Chroniton torpedo launcher, Mark 12. 90 degree targeting arc, 2737 kinetic damage, 273 DPS, 25% chance significantly reduce flight speed and turn rate for 10 seconds, ignore 100% of target shields, chance increased to 50% with chronometric focusing array, plus 20% critical severity. It's part of the chronometric calculations. So you need a chronometric Polaron 360 degree energy weapon, a chronometric Polaron energy weapon, Crinum Chroniton torpedo launcher, which we just got, and then a chronometric capacitor, and that will get you a 2, 3, and 4 piece bonus set, cyclical auxiliary conduits, chronometric energy converter, chronometric focusing array. So it's part of a set. That's very cool. Let's see what the set does. Set 2 bonus is called cyclical auxiliary conduits, plus 3.2 to auxiliary power settings. Bonus increases a low power. Very good for a science ship. Very good for a ship also using auxiliary to boost DPS, which you can do with a certain trait. Chronometric energy converter. Target self, 2-minute recharge to self. Exotic damage for 15 seconds. Ooh, plus some of exotic weapon damage for 15 seconds. So basically more exotic weapon damage, okay. And then this focusing array increases the proc chance of the Crinum Chroniton torpedo to 50% and increases the duration of the chronometric energy converter to 30 seconds. So this is all part of like a Crinum stuff. You're going to need the Crinum ships and other things to get all these parts, and probably, I'm not sure where all the parts come from exactly, but I'm sure some of you guys will know and can post in the comments for us and let us know where all the components come from. But obviously, I don't have access to anything else right now, so all I have is this Chroniton torpedo launcher, and it honestly does not benefit me right now. I guess I could try it. I mean, it wouldn't hurt. I really do like my quantum torpedo, but we could try the Chroniton one, and just see what it looks like and see how it works, and just check it out. Might as well. I don't have any of the other pieces to it, but we'll just try it out and see how it works. Can't hurt. Now let's go take a closer look at this ship, the Alberta. So here's what it looks like. Very Crinum-esque. Very, very familiar Crinum design. It comes with Coalition Disruptor. What's a Coalition Disruptor? Energy weapons designed. Coalition Disruptors are designed to work in tandem with one another by reducing the target's resistance, specifically to disruptor damage, to a larger degree than standard disruptors affect all damage resistance. This debuff also lasts longer, and unlike standard disruptor effects, it can stack up to 5 times from a single source. Huh, so I have heard of coalition weaponry before, but not a lot of people use it. Apparently, they are thinking that disruptors are the best thing for this Crinum science vessel. So there you go. Here is the timeline stabilizer that comes with this ship. Now, can you put this on any other ship? Bound a character, cannot equip more of one. Okay, let's see what this does. A plus 15% cooldown reduction on science bridge officer abilities. PBAOE, 3 kilometers. Foe, negative speed, negative turn. Recharge, self, plus charge, plus firing rate. Self, 15 to 30% firing cycle haste. Oh, that could be really cool for our cannons. Can you imagine a firing cycle haste on our cannons that are already crazily a lot of them? Bridge officer and captain ability recharge time reduction every second. Increases recharge times of abilities by 50%. Foe reduces impulse speed and foe reduces turn rate. Again, a part of another set called Flagship Technologies. Got flagship modification, deadly response, flagship technologies. You need the universal adaptive emergency systems, the universal dampening wave emitter, and the flagship tactical computer. Plus 2% critical chance, plus 3 flight turn rate. When receiving damage while a shield facing is depleted, 10% chance to apply deadly response to self, 2,500 temporary hit points, and all damage. Ooh, that's cool. Flagship, starship, control power, console powers, adaptive emergency systems, increases duration. Wow, okay. Well, a lot of stuff there. I believe that's going to come from the new flagship bundle that's been out. If you go to the Z store, should be able to find it somewhere. There's some kind of flagship. Yeah, the T6 cross-faction flagship bundle. That's if you want all of them. But it's the new flagship thing. I guess that's where it's getting the consoles from, is from those three Federation ships. That's what I'm guessing. Let me know if I'm wrong, but I'm guessing. Okay. I wonder if we can put it on our ship. I'm going to try. You know what? We can! Wow. We can put this console on our ship. Well, we're going to do that then. You can go away, biometrics, and we are getting now this really cool thing called Timeline Stabilizer on our ship. There we go, guys. So we now have the Crinum Chronoton Torpedo from the Science Crinum ship, and we have its universal console, the Timeline Stabilizer, as well. So we got two very unique things on our ship that normally we would not have had, but we do have now because of the 6th anniversary. Now, I'm not going to fly the Alberta yet. This is going to stay here for a while. I am happy with our patrol escort right now, so I'm going to keep using it. Plus 15 to exotic damage, plus 10 shield hit points, healing, shield regeneration, improved feedback pulse. That's right. They're trying to bring in feedback pulse again. Okay, let's see what this timeline stabilizer looks like in space. Real interested in that. I'm real interested to see what the Chronoton torpedo looks like as well, but I guess we'll wait for the next mission to see that. Do I need to add a button for you? Probably so. Okay, we have this timeline stabilizer. So, again, it affects foe, but to ourself, we get this firing cycle haste. I'm interested to see how that works. And we get a bridge officer and captain ability recharge time reduction. Okay, this is cool. Let's see what the effect looks like. Whoa!
Ship is under attack.
Look at that! Got like tentacles coming out of my ship. I'm tentacle ship all of a sudden. It's got a radiating pulse kind of thing that went around my ship. Let's let the reduce cool down, and I'll zoom out and look at that ability again. That looked cool. That was a cool effect. I liked that. Let's see what our... Where's my... Oh, it's already showing. I want to see what my damages on this Chronoton torpedo. So the DPS I'm doing on this Chronoton torpedo is 397. That's less than the Quantum one. A lot less, but I'm doing 3977 kinetic damage. And then it has all these other things associated with it. I guess this ignore 100% of target shields is probably really cool. So we'll see how that Chronoton torpedo works out. See, my DPS is really good on these cannons right now for this level of character, so I really don't want to change anything out on this ship. I like it the way it is for right now. We'll just keep earning energy credits so that I can, you know, upgrade more things. I'm up to 695,000 energy credits, so we're getting there. It's almost reduced. I am doing Admiralty missions, so basically that's how I'm earning energy.
Congratulations, Admiral.
There we go. Now we're level 54, so there you go. The Admiralty system is really, really nice for leveling up, earning XP, and earning specialization points, because I love me those specialization points. I'm not using attack patterns. Or no, I am using attack patterns. Why would I say that? I'm stupid. So let's, let's add that. There we go. So this one is, when activating attack patterns, you get temporary hit points. That's right. So that's going to make our ship even better. So check this out. When I hit attack pattern, I don't think Alpha does it. Yeah, Alpha doesn't do it. But maybe, does Gamma, Omega do it? Yes, temporary hit points for 15 seconds. So Alpha does not give us that, but Omega will. Yeah, there we go. Now it turned pink. Now temporary hit points, 2407. So there we go. Every time we use Omega, we will get temporary hit points on our ship because of that specialization ability. So isn't that cool? I like that. That'll make us better. Better, 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 better. All right, here we go. I'm going to zoom all the way out. And let's activate.
Warning. Ship is
wow.
Under attack.
Wow. Hey, that's pretty cool. Well, there you go, everybody. We have some really cool abilities we can use now on enemies. I can't wait to try the next mission because we've got a Chronoton Torpedo to check out. We've got a Timeline Stabilizer to check out. And what was the other thing? Oh yeah, we've got temporary hit points now when we activate Attack Pattern Omega because of that specialization. So our ship is automatically better. Look at my turn rate too. My turn rate is so good. I like that. What is my turn rate buff from the specialization? It is... wrong button. I am getting plus 15% turn rate buff from pilot specialization right now. If you complete all of the pilot specialization, you get a plus 40% turn rate. 40%. So really cool. Alright, yeah, this is good. Our character is building and building, getting better and better. I'm glad that I opened up the Crinum Science ship. I should be able to now use it as a Doff ship. So it should show up here, and it does. Crinum Science Vessel, Tier 6. So I can use it as a Doff ship, or a Admiralty ship, I should say. So that will really help the Admiralty system quite well. So it's all good. It gave us a torpedo, and it gave us a Timeline Stabilizer, and it gave us the ability to use it in the Admiralty system. So yeah, it was worth opening that ship. I don't know why I was thinking I would wait till 60 to open that ship. What a stupid idea. Sometimes I can be stupid. Sometimes you feel like a nut. Sometimes you are a nut. Almond Joy's got nuts. Apparently so do I. All right, everybody. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned for the next one, and we will get started on the Solanae Dyson Sphere stuff, storyline. So that will be very, very interesting stuff to get into. Thank you all for watching, and stay tuned for the next one.